Or whatever.
Hey, Dino fans, D-Rex here. Today we're going to take a look at the Dilophosaurus and Indoraptor basic Jurassic World figures by Mattel. These are available at Kohl's in the United States. Kohl's often offers coupons that will allow you to get things at a much cheaper price than retail. And also, I would like to add that they are opening on Thanksgiving afternoon at 5. If you're planning to do Black Friday shopping on Thanksgiving Day on Thursday, you might want to make a stop at Kohl's to check out their Jurassic toys. They did have several action figures in stock from Wave 1 and 2. They had the monster truck Jeep, as well as some other things. And the Wave 1 of these basic figures, in addition to the new ones. We have the Jurassic World logo, as well as the artwork with Owen and Blue. And if we take a look at the back of the packaging, we can see it has the logo as well as the blue background and a collection shot. Now, this collection shot shows Blue, Owen, the Dilophosaurus, and the Indoraptor. The other two figures are of Red Raptor and the Pachycephalosaurus. The Dilophosaurus product number is F, V as in Victor, L38, and the Indoraptor is FNY45. Once you remove the figures from their outer boxes, you can see they are held onto their backing with little plastic straps. Cut the plastic straps and remove them from their backing. Similar to Wave 1, you'll need to attach the tail on both of your new figures. There aren't really any alignment marks on the pin or inside the hole, so what you'll want to look for is that there are ridges on the skin of the animal, and there are ridges on either side of the bottom of the tail for the Dilophosaurus. So you line up the peg and you line up the skin patterns and push. Make sure you hear that click, and your Dilophosaurus is assembled. The Indoraptor actually does have an alignment pin. There's a notch in the bottom of the hole, and there's a notch on the bottom of the peg. So you line up the tail with the body, and once again push until you hear the click. Similar to Wave 1 of the basic figures, their mouths do not open and their heads do not move. They do have arms that will move forward and back, as well as legs that move forward and back, and these have feet that rotate so you can stabilize the way they're standing. They also have tails that move. They don't have a great deal of movement from side to side, but they will move up and down. The one thing I have to say about this Indoraptor is that unlike the grab and growl Indoraptor and the straight up villain dino ultimate Indoraptor, this one will not stand in multiple poses. As soon as I let go, this one falls flat. Because of the length of the body and the way that it's posed. So you're basically stuck, even though the legs do move, you're basically stuck with the animal in a crouching four-legged position. And it is quite narrow also, which I'm sure contributes to the problem. It's still a very pretty animal though. Here's a close-up look at the sculpt. I kind of like the black teeth. They don't stick out and look goofy or anything. It does still have the red eye and the kind of reverse cardinal pattern, as well as the metallic paint down the sides. The scaling and the quills and everything on the skin is the same pattern. So they've been true to the character in this sculpt, as well as the others. Very snake-like, very shiny. Very beautiful animal. Now, as for the Dilophosaur, the tail movement is very slight, similarly to the Indoraptor. The legs move and the feet rotate. The arms will move forward and back, and it has a frill. You can choose to fold the frill out. It has a little barrel hinge in the back, or you can fold it back like that. I usually prefer to have it displayed. Now, this is the same paint scheme as the Attack Pack Dilophosaur. It's one of the smaller ones from Mattel. And like the other basic figures, I think this would be an excellent candidate for a repaint. It does have a very nice crest on top of its head. There's a very nice red eye on both sides. Nice sharp teeth. Although they're not painted, they are sculpted, so you can see them. We have pebbling on the skin. Nice little ridge down the back. Musculature, skin folds, ribs, like you see in the first movie. For being basic figures, they're good-looking toys. Here you can see how the Dilophosaurus pairs up with the basic Owen figure. I hope that one day we get a basic Claire or at least some other figure besides Owen. But for now, Owen is the human we have. The Indoraptor, compared to Owen, is ridiculously small. I understand why. They wanted to keep the package sizing and the scale of the animals the same, but this is probably more in scale with the 3 3/4 action figures than it is with this figure. That's all the time I have for this video, but if you are collecting the basic figures, be sure to stop by the Kohl's website or your local Kohl's department store and check out their toy section. They have expanded the toys for the holiday season, and there are many, many things available. There's also tons and tons of clothes in the boys department for Jurassic. And like I said, for basic figures, these look really good. Nice sculpts, decent paint, and at least in terms of the Dilophosaur, reasonable scale with the basic figure Owen. Just a few more days left until Black Friday. I hope that you're making your lists and checking them twice. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and hit the bell icon to be notified when I upload a new video. Until next time, happy hunting. That's because of the length and the way it's... Jeez. Fall over, everybody.